I tell you what worries me is the general black clouds in the economy, Keith. And it plays out today, analysis from Barrenjoey, which is a financial company looking closely at the books of the banks, reckons there's about $270 billion worth of Australian home loans that are at risk of defaulting or being classified as severely stressed. Now, this says to me, global financial crisis stuff back in 2008, the subprime disaster. Now, I'm not saying those home loans are subprime in how they're assessed and people got the money in the first place, but that default risk, you know, almost $300 billion, that's a worry.
Oh, absolutely, Peter. And this was one of the challenges. Yeah, there was fear of missing out. The housing market was hot and kept going up. People had an opportunity to buy in with very, very low interest rates. I actually bought a property myself, but I'd worked on about 6%, and I think we're already past that already. I was expecting that to take some time. But the real danger here was everyone was trying to get a roof over their head. They couldn't get rentals. They found a way into the market. And now with these massive increases in interest rates, and let's not mess around, this is all in the lap of the Labor government. Well, there's some real risk they'll default, and that means they'll lose their homes.
Hey, I was just talking about property rights in WA and the assault on farmers over there, but it's coming to a town near you because the Federal Housing Minister, Julie Collins, she says she now supports regulatory interventions into the Airbnb market. She says that's impacting rents. Well, it may well be, Gary, but if you own your own home and you want to put tenants in it permanently, that's one thing. You want to sell it, fine. You want to Airbnb it. Surely, if you own your own house in this country, we used to believe in private property rights.
Yeah, but this mob don't believe in private property rights. And let's face it, their partners in this economic crime, the Greens, they want to tax every family home. And Peter, the problem now is the government is saying they won't tax the family home. But what is a family home? They're now trying to tell you how to use your home. Is a family home three bedrooms, one bathroom, anything above that? Well, it's up for the government to inspect. And I don't think I'm overhyping this to say that the real genuine fear is this is the thin edge of the wedge. Airbnb, one day we say nothing. They're going to come for the family home that's, say, four bedrooms, two bathrooms next. Anything is possible. You know, if you've got three spare bedrooms in your house, they may well tell you you've got to take a few homeless people in. That's the sort of nonsense we're seeing from this, frankly, Stalinist style of government that we've now got in this country. Yeah. It's bloody frightening, Peter.